Hey folks, Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and welcome to Copycat Friday. In this weekly series, we recreate video effects from famous films and music clips. Today, we're having a look at the band Why Don't We and our music video 8 Letters, in which we can see these floating objects that suddenly start to twirl around super fast. Now, this effect has also been seen in Sun is Shining from Maxwell, so the idea could come from either. It doesn't matter, we are gonna make some paper fly around this. But first, let's have a look at this high-quality stock clip of a plane and fly over to our sponsor Storyblocks to discover hundreds of thousands more studio-quality stock clips, transitions, overlays, After Effects templates, and so much more. If you're into video editing or visual effects, then Storyblocks is a must-have subscription, as you can download unlimited video assets for a single price per year. I can highly recommend to check it out yourself. You can do so by clicking the first link in the description below. And now let's fly through the church. Welcome to church, guys. First of all, a big thanks to the community for letting us film right here. Now let's talk about the lighting. In the music video, you can see these three stage lights in the back. These are warm lights, which is pretty cool in that church. Now we kind of recreated that. For the convenience, we are working with four lights, but we do have that same feeling to it. We have four LED lights right here, which are daylight balanced. That means it's more cold light. So that's why we've wrapped orange filters around them to also make them appear like tungsten lighting and get that same warm tone to it. Then over here, we have our smoke machine, which is warming up. We're going to fill the room with some mist later on, and that way we are really going to get those rays of lights throughout the entire church. We've got some beautiful windows out there, and the sun is shining on those windows, which is gonna be really cool. Now let's have a look over there. And here we've got the frontal lighting. We are working again with LED lights, but this time we are keeping them at daylight balanced color temperature. Because of that, we can set the camera to also daylight and just have normal skin tones, but the lighting in the back will be much more warmer, which is gonna be really cool. We've got a huge softbox right here because we wanna have soft lighting over my skin tones. So yeah, that's basically the lighting setup and all that we need to start shooting. Then the only thing that you have to do to take your shot is take out your tripod and put the camera on there. Now you can also move your tripod through the space, but that is going to be a lot more complicated when we're going to create the paper particles in After Effects. However, we have made a tutorial in the past, which was inspired by the trailer of 13 Reasons Why, which you can find a link to in the description below that does cover how to do that. So we've just made the shots that we need, but before we're gonna pack everything up, there's one last thing that we have to do, and that is make a shot of the paper itself. And we're gonna use this as a particle for the thousands of papers that are gonna fly around us. So just take a shot of this in the same lighting conditions as you were standing in. The general criteria is just filming this paper, and we're gonna grab one frame out of it, but you can also just grab a picture from this paper, of course.
We are back at the office. Let's jump into After Effects.
Let's start by placing our shot into a new composition. Now, since we want to have the papers turn around us, we're going to make a duplication of our clip by hitting Ctrl D. With the top clip selected, head over to the toolbox and pick the pen tool. With this, you can draw a rough mask around the subject. If you are moving in your shot, you might need to go into your mask properties, enable the mask path animation, and change it over time so that the mask will follow you. Lastly, increase the feather a bunch. Now we can now go ahead and start creating the whirlwind of papers. From the effects library, I search for the particle world effect. Drag that onto the top clip, which we've created that mask on previously. Already you can see a bunch of generated particles. Now these particles is obviously not what we want to work with. So let's locate the clip or the photo that you took of the soul paper. Add it to the composition and cut it out with a mask. And of course, you can also do this inside Photoshop. If you are working with a clip in here though, then it's important to freeze it. Now you can do so by right-clicking on that layer, go to Time, and then choose Freeze Frame. Now to make that paper a bit more organic, I'm gonna search for the Bend It effect and drag that to the layer. And this allows me to bend the paper a little bit. You can also apply other effects in here if you'd like to make any adjustments to the paper particle. So once that is ready, we can go ahead and disable the output of the layer since we don't need it in the comp. but we're gonna select the top clip again, which holds the particle world effect. And from the particle property, I'm gonna change the particle type to textured quad polygon. And this allows me to expand the texture property and target the paper layer. Make sure to also change the second drop-down menu to effects and masks, or else it won't use the bended effect which we've applied on it earlier. All right, so far so good. We've got the papers in our scene. Next up, we're gonna have to make some adjustments to it to make it twirl around me. First of all, we're gonna dive into the physics options and change the animation to viscous. And this will make the particles spread evenly into the space. And there is also a twirl option, but we found out that some particles would behave pretty weird that we couldn't control anymore. So that's why we went for the viscose. No idea if I pronounced that right, but hey, let me know in the comments. Currently, the particles start from the middle and then they fall down. So first of all, I'm gonna set the gravity to zero so that they don't fall anymore. And finally, I'm gonna set the velocity to zero as well so that the particles stay nicely in place. Now, they are all grouped together now, and to fix that, we're diving into the producer property. From here, we wanna adjust the stretch radius out for all the axes. Try to fill up the room nicely. If you do notice that the particles are not utilizing the space like you want them to, you can always dive back into this option later on. You can also use the position properties above to move the entire particle cloud around and have them sit exactly where you want. All right, we've got the papers in place. Now let's focus on the papers itself. I'm gonna dive into the particle options. The rotation speed will determine how fast the papers have to turn around their own axis, so you can increase this. The particles have a birth and a death. They come in and go away. From the bird size and dead size, you can set the size of the papers upon reveal and ending. Usually the bird size is gonna be a little bit bigger as the dead size, and this way the papers will slowly decrease in scale over time, making the entire cloud of papers more organic. And finally, set the opacity to 100. Next up, go to the top where you can find the birth rate. With this setting, we can control how many papers you would like to see in your shot. And with the longevity, I'm not sure, let me know in the comments. Anyways, with that setting, we can choose how long each paper has to live. But again, like I said before, you might want to go back and forward between these settings. All right, let's jump into the last setting, which can be found under extras. And here comes the setting where we can really make the papers become part of the scene. First of all, enable composite with original. And this will make your subject, which we've masked out in the beginning, to become part of the 3D space of the particles. We can then open up the effects camera property and move the virtual camera around using the parameters right here. Changing the distance, you can move the papers in the back to actually be behind the subject. And using the grid, we can try to align the floor to make it match with the real camera. You can also change the focal length, the FOV, to make the papers match with your wide angle or tele lens. Next up, open the depth queue, change it to fade and increase the distance value. And this will make the papers and the background softer, having them out of focus. And finally is the light direction. And this basically moves the virtual light, which allows you to match the lighting from the real shot with the virtual papers. And those were all the settings. I know it's much, but you've just learned how to work with a very powerful and super popular particle effect inside After Effects. Good job. Now there's one last problem. The papers don't actually move around. But that's super easily done. Just go back into the effects camera property and start animation for the rotation Y. Then go forward in time and change that rotation. Now those papers will flow around you like a whirlwind, but it's missing some motion blur. So from your layer properties, make sure to enable motion blur from there. And by the way, guys, if you can't find these settings, then just right-click into your columns, choose columns, and make sure that the switches are selected. And then the very final step now is to enable motion blur for the entire composition with this nifty button right here. And that's it. Thank you, Cinecom crew, for the awesome work. Thank you, Storyblocks, for the support. That wasn't good. That's better. And of course, thank you for watching. And as always, stay creative.
Have you ever seen such a big key? Awesome.
Big doesn't always mean good because they installed a second lock. Probably this is the safest lock. There we go.
Good point.